Good morning, children. I am Preeta Rani, again here to deal with the second session of our grammar class. I hope you all have received the notes of the first session, that is common nouns. So the first lesson of our grammar portion deals with common and proper nouns. In the last class, we studied what is a noun and what is a common noun. I hope you all have understood what's a noun because you have studied it in your previous classes. In your first standard, second standard, you all studied what is a noun with a name, naming word. Okay, so what is a naming word? It's a name. Name given to a particular person, place, animal, thing, etc. So everything that is around us has a name. So that is called a naming word or a noun. And in the last class, we have dealt with common nouns. And today, we are going to find out what is a proper noun. Before that, let us recap. What is a common noun? Common noun is a name given in general to person, place, thing, animal, etc. If I say a dog, it's a common noun. A man is a common noun. A boy, common noun. A girl, common noun. So, a name given in general is a common noun. Then, what is a proper noun? Proper noun means it's a name given in particular to a person, place, thing, or animal. For example, if I say a dog, it's a common noun because all kinds of that particular animal is named as dog. If I say chair, it's a common noun. If I say pen, it's a common noun. If I say lady, it's a common noun. Clear? But if I mention myself as Preeta, then that is the particular name given to me. Okay. You have a teacher. Teacher is a common noun. But my name is Preeta. So, Preeta is the particular name given to me. So, that is proper noun. So, what's a proper noun? Proper noun is the name given in particular. Here we have a lot of pictures. We can go through these pictures. One is the picture of a boy, a girl, a building there, then an animal here, another building, another one. So these are the names of some persons, I mean pictures of some persons and places, buildings, etc. But if I say it is a boy, we can say it's a common noun because all the kind of these kind of people are called boys, isn't it? But if we give a special name to that boy, here comes Rahul. Then Rahul is the special name, the particular name given to this boy. Then Rahul is a proper noun. So proper noun is the particular name given to the boy. So boy is a common noun, but Rahul is the proper noun. Clear? Here we have a picture of a girl. Girl is a common noun. But if we give a name, Aditi, then Aditi is a proper noun. And see Rahul, their R is capital letter. Remember, all the proper nouns begin with a capital letter. Keep it in mind. Okay, so proper nouns are special names and we write the special names in capital letter. All the proper nouns are written in capital letters. Clear? So next we have a picture here and the picture is of, I think you are familiar with this picture. Yes, it is the world famous Taj Mahal. The name of that particular building. Okay, See here, Taj Mahal begins with capital letter. Understood? So, proper noun always begin with capital letter. And we here we have a dog. If I say a dog, it's a common noun. But if I say Rocky, then that Rocky is the name given to that particular animal. So Rocky is a proper noun. It's a special name. Clear? Here we have another one, a hospital. And if we say hospital, it is common noun. But if we say Kim's Hospital, it is the name of this particular hospital. So then it is proper noun. Clear? If we simply say hospital, it is common noun. But if we particularly mention the name of that hospital, then it becomes proper noun. Clear? Okay. Next we have a building here. And what is a building? Yeah, school, isn't it? Okay, so if we say school, then it is common. But if we say Sarvodaya Vidyalaya, it is proper. So do you understand the difference between common and proper noun? Common noun means it's a general name. General name given to a person, place, animal or thing. Proper noun means it's a particular name, the special names we give to a person, place, animal or thing. Is it clear? Okay, so now we can just go through the definition, proper nouns. The definition is there in your textbook itself. So this is it. Proper nouns are the special names of people, places, animals or things. They are the special names. And always remember, proper nouns begin with capital letters. Okay? Proper nouns always begin with capital letter. Here we have the examples. Aditi, begin with capital letter. Rahul, Mumbai, Taj Mahal. Everything begins with capital letter. Clear? And the names of the days of the week. That is, if you say Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, they are all proper nouns. So we have to begin it with capital letter. The names of the months, they are also proper nouns. And the special days, just like if we say the Republic Day, Diwali, Onam, they are all, Christmas, etc. They are all special days. So remember, proper nouns means it is the name given in special. And the names of the days of the week. Which are the days of the week? Yeah, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. So these Sunday, Monday, Tuesday till Saturday, they are all proper nouns and they all begin with capital letter. Okay, and the days and the names of the months. So which are the names of the months? January, February, March, like that. So all those names of the months should be written in capital letter. Clear? Then the special days. Special days just like a Republic Day, Independence Day, the names of the festivals, etc. should be written in capital letter. It should begin with capital letter and they are all considered as proper nouns. Clear? See the examples here. Wednesday, W is in capital letter. March, again M is in capital letter. Republic D, that R and D should be in capital letter. Is it clear? Okay, so we can move to the exercise in your textbook. See the exercise here. Circle the proper nouns in the following sentences. Hope you all have your textbook in front of you. Take your pencil and we can now do the exercise. Can we circle the proper nouns? I think you understand what a proper noun is. Have you? Okay. The first question is, Asif lives in Kolkata near the Howrah Bridge. Asif lives in Kolkata near the Howrah Bridge. So can you say which are the proper nouns? Which are the proper nouns here? We have, yeah, how many proper nouns in the first sentence? Three. Which are they? As if is the name of a person. Kolkata is the name of a place. Then Howrah Bridge, another name of a place. Clear? So these are the names of the special names given to a person and places. So they are all proper nouns, and remember, see, listen, they are all written in capital letter. Asif A is in capital letter, Kolkata K capital letter, Howrah Bridge H and B is in capital letter. Clear? Now the second one, my birthday was on the last Saturday in March. My birthday was on the last Saturday in March. Any proper noun? Yeah, we have two proper nouns. Which are they? Yeah, Saturday, it is the days of the week, and March, name of a month. Clear? So circle Saturday and March. Circle it along with me, all of you. Do it. So birthday was on the last Saturday. Saturday and March are proper nouns. Last Diwali, we went to Jaipur for a holiday. Last Diwali, we went to Jaipur for a holiday. Can you identify the proper nouns here? Yeah, Diwali. You can easily identify the proper nouns because I told you proper noun begin with a capital letter. So here Diwali is a proper noun because it's the name of a festival. Clear? And we have Jaipur, it's the name of a place. Clear to you? Now, Simran bought a new pair of shoes. Simran bought a new pair of shoes. Any proper noun? Yes, Simran, name of a girl. Clear? Now, Enid Blyton is my favorite author. Any proper noun? Yes, Enid Blyton is the proper noun given to that particular author. My pet parrot Polly makes a lot of noise. My pet parrot Polly makes a lot of noise. So what is the name given to the parrot? Polly. If you say parrot, it is a common noun, but if you say Polly, it's a proper noun. Clear? Because that special name is given to the parrot. Is it clear, all of you? Can we move to the next one? Next exercise. Exercise D. Some proper nouns in the following sentences are not written correctly. Correct them and rewrite the sentence. So there you have the sentences. Below that some lines are given. You can write down the answer in those lines given. Clear? Now, just mark what is the correction. You can rewrite the sentence later in those lines. Okay? So first, you just mark the corrections. Is it clear? If you are writing the whole sentence, it will take time. You can write the sentences later. First, mark the corrections. Is it clear to you? See, I think Roger Federer is the world's best tennis player. I think Roger Federer is the world's best tennis player. So first we have to read the sentence. After reading the sentence, identify whether there is a proper noun in the sentence. So if there is a proper noun, what we have to do? We have to change those proper nouns into, yeah, you have to begin those proper nouns into capital letter. Okay, is there any proper noun here in the first sentence? I think Roger Federer is the world's best tennis player. Is there any proper noun? Yes, we have Roger Federer. So if we identify the proper noun in that sentence, what we have to do? We have to change the first letter into capital letter. Clear? So what is the proper noun here? Roger Federer. So that R should be capital letter, then federal, F should be capital letter. Clear? I think Roger Federer, R and F should be capital letter. Then what will be the answer? I think Roger Federer is the world's best tennis player. You can rewrite the answer. Clear? So what is the second question here? I have a pet dog called Tipsy. Is there any proper noun? Okay, we have, what is it? Tipsy, so that T should be capital letter. So what is the answer there? I have a pet dog called Tipsy. Change the small letter to capital letter because it's a proper noun. Dog is a common noun. Clear? Now the third one. I went to Shimla in the summer holidays. I went to Shimla in the summer holidays. There, yes, should be capital letter. So what is the answer? I went to Shimla in the summer holidays. S should be capital letter because it's a proper noun and the name of a place. And the fourth one, the Quran is the holy book of Muslims. Is there any proper noun? Yes, we have. The name of the book is given there, Quran, and the name of a religion is given there, Muslims. Those two nouns should be changed and it should begin with capital letters. The Quran is the holy book of Muslims. Is it clear? Now the next question. Santa Claus brings us gifts on Christmas. Which are the proper nouns? Yeah, surely we have. Santa, S, and Claus, C, then Christmas, it is C. Santa Claus brings us gifts on Christmas. So the answer is S and C of Santa Claus because it's a proper noun and Christmas is the name of a festival. Clear? We will go to the National Museum on Wednesday. Yeah, National Museum is the name of a place. It should be capital letter. Wednesday is the name of a day in the week. So it should be capital letter. We will go to the National Museum on Wednesday. N, M and W should be capital letter. Clear? So proper noun means it's a name, it's a special name given to person, place, animal or thing. So the last example is given there. In column A are some nouns and in column B are the some proper nouns and in column B the common nouns that match with them. Draw lines to join them correctly. So I think that instead of drawing lines, you can simply mark the numbers here. Clear? It will be more clear to you. Okay? So the first in column A, we can read the words given here, Sarojini Naidu. It's a proper noun. Sarojini Naidu is the name of a famous poet. Harry Potter, you may be familiar with Harry Potter. Okay? Red Fort, Paris, Bible, Mickey Mouse, Monday and Saina Nehwal. On column B, we have building, poet, city, cartoon character, boy wizard, holy book, sports person and day of the week. So column A we have proper nouns and column B we have common nouns. Can we join it? Can we? Okay, Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu, I told you she's a famous poet. So write number, sorry, write number one here by the side of the word poet. Clear? Harry Potter. Who is the Harry Potter? Yeah, boy wizard. There is a series of book Harry Potter written by J.K. Rowling. I think most of you have seen films of Harry Potter. Okay, if not, try to see it. You are getting a lot of time now at home. Make use of the time watching movies and all Harry Potter written by J.K. Rowling. The Red Fort. Red Fort is the name of a Building, yes. Now Paris. Paris is a city. Okay? Then the Bible. Bible is a holy book. Bible is a holy book. And we have the Mickey Mouse. Mickey Mouse is the cartoon character. And Monday, day of the week, number 7. Saina Nehwal is a sports person, number 8. Is it clear? So this is the way you have to join the two columns with the proper noun and the common noun. Is it clear? Okay, I think the lesson is over. Before ending, this year you have a book. You must keep a book for composition. For English, you have composition and you have to keep a notebook, an 80 pages notebook for composition. Okay, so this is the first composition that you are going to study. No need to copy this down now. It will be there. The notes of this comprehension passage will be sent to you. Okay, you can copy that. Okay, this is only an example. I'm just going to teach you how to do a comprehension passage. Okay, so this is the first composition that you are going to study. So we have studied proper and common nouns, and I think that you all have understood that. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can call me personally. Okay. Now you are going to study about compositions, and this is the first composition that we are going to give you. You will get notes of compositions and of this comprehension passage, one example and another comprehension passage also. And you have to copy down those comprehension passages in the composition notebook. And try to write on the right hand side of the notebook. Never write on the left hand side. You'll have a composition book, and on the composition book you have to write on the right hand side very neatly and legibly. Okay, the teachers will correct the book when you come back to school. Just copy down the composition, this comprehension passage and the paragraph. And after that, you'll get some question answers that also you have to write in your composition book. First, today I'm going to just teach you what is a comprehension passage and how to answer the comprehension passage. Is it clear? See, comprehension passage means you'll get a paragraph, a very simple paragraph, maybe a story. Just read the paragraph 2 or 3 times. Clear? Just read this paragraph 2 or 3 times, and after this paragraph you will have some questions. You have to answer these questions. Is it clear? So it's very easy for you to do. First, you read the paragraph given, and after reading the paragraph, try to find out the answers of those particular questions from this paragraph given. You can easily identify the answers. Can we do it here? See, read this passage carefully and answer the questions given below. The passage is, once a fox fell into a deep well. He tried his best but could not get out. So he just waited for someone to come and help. Soon a god passed by. The fox cried out to her, "The water here is cool and sweet. The water here is cool and sweet. Why don't you come and have a drink?" The god was quite silly. Without thinking even for a moment, she jumped into the well. When she had taken a drink, she asked the fox, "How will we get out?" The fox said, "Please stand on your hind legs. I will climb up your head and get out. Then I'll help you to get out." The guard agreed. But when the fox had got out, he just ran away. The guard was left in the well. She was drowned after some time. So, read the passage once again. You'll understand the story. A fox fell into the well. He tried his best to get out, but he couldn't able to do that. At that time, a guard came, passed by. He called out, and the guard was very foolish. And the fox said that, "Just jump into the well. Here the water is very cool and sweet." The guard jumped into the well. After drinking the water, the guard tried to come out of the well, but she also couldn't come out. So he asked, "How could we come out of it?" So what did the fox say? "You just stand on your hind legs. I'll climb on you. I'll get out of the well. After that, I'll help you to come out." But after coming out, did the fox help the guard to come out? No. He ran away. Could the guard come out of the well? No. It was there in the well, drank the water and died. So read the passage again and again till you understand what it is. And after that, I told you there will be a set of questions. After going through the questions, you can identify how you can answer from the passage. So we can see what are the questions given here. What happened to the fox? What happened to the fox? What happened to the fox? Before going into the passage, can we answer what happened to the fox? Yeah, the fox fell into a deep well. What happened to the fox? It fell into a deep well. See, the fox fell into a deep well. No need to write the question and answer now. Remember, it will be there in your students' portal. The notes are there. Just listen to me. Okay. Now, what is the second question? What did the fox do? When the fox fell into the well, what did he do? What did he do? Did he simply sit there in the well? No. He tried to get out, but he couldn't able to come out of the well. So that is given there in the passage. What did he do? He tried his best, but he could not get out. So we can answer it. What is it? He tried his best, but could not get out. Clear? So from the passage itself, you can answer those questions. Who passed by after some time? In the passage it is given. Who passed by? Yeah, a guard passed by after some time. Who got out of the well first? Did the guard come out of the well or the fox come out of the well? Surely, who come out of the well? The fox got out of the well first. What happened to the guard in the end? Poor guard. What happened to it in the end? It drank a lot of water and it drowned. What do you mean by drowned? Yeah, it died in the water. The guard was drowned. So this is the way you have to do the comprehension passage. This you have to write in a composition book on the right side of the composition book, not on the left hand side. Clear? So read the passage again and again and again and try to find out the answers from the passage, and remember the key words will be there. The important words in the question you can identify in the passage, and thereby you can answer the questions. Is it clear? Hope you understand proper noun and then how to write the composition passage. Thank you and have a nice day.